Once you have your site selected and some of the preparation done, it's a good idea to plan out what crops and which varieties of those crops you're going to grow. If you really want to be motivated to keep your vegetable garden growing throughout the year and really maximize the space that you have to produce edible crops, it's good to pay attention to that variety selection and make sure that you're growing things that you really enjoy eating. So plant what you're going to eat. Make sure that you are growing something that will be appreciated by you and your family members. Make sure that the crops that you've selected and the cultivars that you've selected actually fit your garden space. There's a huge difference between plant types in many of the different crops. And so if you're looking at beans, you might need a trellis or you might need a smaller space. If you're looking at tomatoes, and they're determinate versus indeterminate, the plants themselves are going to be very different sizes. A lot of things do need to be trellised, and so if you're growing a plant that requires a trellis, try to figure out which type of trellis you're going to use and make sure it's appropriate for your space. Plants that are from different plant families, and that's a useful tool later on when you need to rotate those plant families through your garden space. Choosing the right variety or cultivar of each type of crop is very important. There will be a huge difference in many of the cultivar characteristics, including days to first harvest or the length of harvest. So with respect to cabbage, you may see two different cultivars. One has a 95 days to harvest, so that's seed to time of maturity. There may be a shorter season cabbage that only takes 65 days. So you have to decide whether or not you want the characteristics that are associated with that longer growing cabbage versus the shorter growing that will be 95 days that you won't be able to grow anything else in that particular space in your garden. You also will need to decide which type of variety you're going to grow with respect to whether it's a hybrid, an heirloom, an open pollinated variety, and whether or not it has disease resistance. So many of the heirloom varieties have very little, and in some cases no disease resistance. But disease resistance doesn't mean that they're completely immune to the disease. It just means that they have less chance of getting it or being severely affected by it. Tomatoes are a great example of this. There are so many different diseases that affect tomatoes and many different cultivars of tomatoes that are available for you to select from. So if you're concerned about getting early blight, or maybe you know that your soil is infected with either verticillium or fusarium wilt, you definitely need to select a cultivar that has resistance to those particular diseases.